This presentation covers the measurement of hydraulic conductivity testing using a constant head permeameter. This figure illustrates the key parts of any constant head permeameter. The test consists of a cylindrical specimen of soil with a cross-sectional area of A and a length of L. The top of the specimen is hydraulically connected to an upper reservoir, and the bottom of the specimen is hydraulically connected to a lower reservoir. The reservoirs are designed such that the elevation of water in each is constant. The change in head across the sample, delta H, is then just the difference in the elevation of the water and surface in the upper and lower reservoirs. If we maintain a constant delta H, the flow out of the lower reservoir, Q, will be equal to the flow of water through the sample. We can measure Q by measuring the time it takes for the flow to fill up a container of a known volume. To determine the hydraulic conductivity then, we first compute the hydraulic gradient I as delta H over L. We then use Darcy's law, Q equals KIA, to compute the hydraulic conductivity. To do this, we rearrange the equation to get K on the left-hand side of the equation, and we have K is equal to Q divided by I over A. This photo shows the permeameter we will be using in your lab. The test section containing the soil specimen is located near the bottom of the device. Below the test section is the drain section, which is simply used to hydraulically connect the bottom of the sample to the lower reservoir. Above the test section is a Mariette bottle, which will be used to both control the elevation of the reservoir above the specimen and allow us to compute the flow rate Q. The entire device will be placed into a bucket, which will be used to keep the sample saturated and control the elevation of the lower reservoir. The Mariette bottle contains a lower fill line and an upper vent line. These are used to fill the bottle with water before the test, but are kept closed during the test. The top of the Mariette bottle is sealed, and an adjustable standpipe sticks down the center of the bottle. The standpipe is moved up and down to control the head of water above the specimen. Finally, there is a scale along the side of the Mariette bottle. This will be used to measure the elevation of the bottom of the standpipe and to measure the drop in water level in the bottle. We will measure the drop in water level over time and use this measurement to compute the flow rate through the soil. This picture is a close-up of the soil test section. The test section has a diameter of 15.25 centimeters and a height of 11.66 centimeters. The bottom of the test section is made of a perforated stainless steel sheet. A number 100 wire mesh screen is placed on top of the stainless steel sheet to retain all the soil in the test section. The specimen is prepared by filling the test section with soil and compacting that soil to the desired density. Vibratory compaction is used to densify the soil. Once the test section is filled and compacted, another 100 mesh screen is placed on top of the soil and another perforated stainless steel plate on top of the mesh. This keeps the soil in the test section. The Mariette bottle is then connected to the top of the test section using the neoprene band and hose clamps as shown. This image shows a close-up of the soil specimen in the test section with the Mariette bottle connected above and the drain section connected below. When the entire apparatus is assembled, it's placed in a bucket to saturate the sample. The bucket has a standpipe attached, which will control the elevation of the water in the bucket, thereby creating a fixed elevation for the lower reservoir. This schematic diagram will be used to describe how the test is performed. First, with the upper vent line open, the Mariette bottle is filled through the lower fill line. Once the bottle is filled, both valves are closed. They will remain closed throughout the test. The top of the Mariette bottle standpipe is open to the atmosphere. Therefore, both points A and B are subject to atmospheric pressure. Since the Mariette bottle is sealed in the top, there is a vacuum formed at the top of the bottle. The vacuum is what holds up the column of water in the Mariette bottle. Since A and B are both at atmospheric pressure, they have the same pressure head. Therefore, the change in head across the specimen, delta H, is simply the difference in elevation between the top of the water in the bucket and the bottom of the standpipe in the Mariette bottle. Since we know the length of the specimen L, we can compute the hydraulic gradient as delta H over L. This animation will illustrate how the test is performed. Once the Mariette bottle is filled and the standpipe height set, water will start flowing through the specimen, out the bottom of the permeameter and into the bucket. At the same time, air bubbles will enter the bottle through the standpipe and will travel up to the top of the bottle, and the water level in the Mariette bottle will drop. All this time, water will be flowing out of the standpipe attached to the bucket. During the test, you will measure the initial elevation of the water in the bottle, the final elevation of the water in the bottle, and the time required for the water to drop this distance. The change in elevation can then be determined. You now have all the data needed to compute the hydraulic conductivity. The computations are, first, compute the hydraulic gradient as delta H over I. The volume V flowing through the sample is the inside diameter of the Mariette bottle squared minus the outside diameter of the Mariette bottle squared times pi divided by 4, all times the change in elevation. Once you know the volume, you can calculate the flow rate Q as V over delta T. And finally, you can compute the hydraulic gradient K as Q over the quantity I times A. You should make measurements at 3 or 4 different gradients for each specimen by adjusting the elevation of the standpipe and the Mariette bottle. This will give you multiple measurements which you can average to get an average hydraulic conic gradient. That's all there is to it. It's really a simple test. Have fun with it.
Es esto, es esto, eso es todo, amigos.